Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zollo Tech, and today Apple released iOS 14.5 Beta 6. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers. Usually by the time I make this video live, it's out to public beta testers. At the time of recording it, it's not out yet, but I'll let you know in the comments below. And this one came in at 260.9 megabytes on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. It's about the same size, around 200 megabytes or so, on the iPhone 11 and iPhone 6S Plus that I have here. And along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 14.5 Beta 6 that I have on my 12.9 inch iPad Pro from 2020, along with watchOS 7.4 Beta 6, which just finished installing on this Apple Watch. And then they also released tvOS 14.5 Beta 6 and macOS Big Sur 11.3 Beta 6 to developers. Those are all out now and soon to public beta testers. Let's take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then general, then about, and you can see the build number is 18E5194A. And this particular update does have a couple changes in it. And there is no modem update in this update. So this one doesn't have any modem changes. So if you're having connectivity issues, whether that be with 5G or anything else on your 12 Pro Max or any of the other devices, I've yet to see any sort of modem update on any of those. So it seems like Apple may be getting this fixed and taken care of, so we should be good there. Now, as far as new features, well, the first thing I can show you is if we go to settings and then we go to Siri and search, under Siri and search, we go to Siri voice, and there's a couple new voices now. Now you have American, Australian, British, Indian, Irish, and South African. And here you can see we have four voice changes or voice choices now. So we'll go to each one. Let me turn the volume up here and I'll go to voice one.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
We'll do that again.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Then we have voice two.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
We have voice three.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
And then voice four.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
And it's a little bit different from before. If we go to settings on beta five, for example, we'll go to Siri and search. I have beta five on the left. Then we'll go to Siri voice. It used to say male and female. Now it just says voice 1, 2, 3, 4. And for Australian, the only one they've added is American. So the only one they've made available now is for American, and you have a couple extra ones. So that's new here as well. And then also, they added this update to everyone, but in Apple Maps, in certain airports in the United States and maybe around the world, it talks about different restrictions for that airport. So some airports have it, some don't, but you'll see at this airport, passengers are required to wear face coverings and practice physical distancing. So there's guidelines for each airport around the country if there are different requirements, for example. So it just makes a difference depending on which one you're looking at. Now there's mention in the code also of possibly a new Apple TV remote. Now that might be in tvOS 14.5 beta 6, but it's talking about pairing a new remote, and hopefully we'll see a new Apple TV soon. We thought there'd be a new event soon, but so far nothing. But basically it says press a button on your remote to get started and then press the center button or touch the surface to continue. So it still sounds like a touch remote, maybe something like we have here or something new. So we'll have to wait and see if Apple also releases that or releases anything like that soon. Now, other than that, there are no physical changes that are in iOS 14.5 beta 6. There's nothing else to see, but there is one resolved issue that's fairly significant, and that has to do with iPhone 11 series phones. Now, for some reason, this issue is specific to iPhone 11 series devices, nothing else. Maybe they'll add this in the future, but what they've said is that battery health reporting systems will calibrate maximum battery capacity and peak performance capability to address inaccurate estimates of battery health reporting for some users. Now, they've gone into more detail into how this works, and they've said that recalibration will occur during regular charge cycles or recharge cycles, and that this process may take a few weeks to complete. So we'll have to wait for different updates, apparently. If you update it, we'll change that. But they said when the recalibration is finished, maximum capacity percentage and peak performance capability data will be updated in the settings app. So maybe you're showing 82% and it really should be 90, or maybe it should be less. Based off this, it should be resolved and be more accurate. Now they've showed what it actually looks like if you have issues with it. So this is what it would look like, where if you have issues or it's recalibrating, it will talk about it. And then ultimately, if it has additional issues, it says recalibration of the battery health reporting system was not successful. An Apple authorized service provider can replace the battery free of charge to restore full performance and capacity. So if there's issues with it and it can't fix the issue, apparently they'll replace the battery for free. So that's good news for those of you having those issues, and hopefully it adds to more accurate reporting of battery health in the future. Now, there's no mentions of fixing green tint or anything like that. However, we know that early betas did fix the green tint. So we'll have to see after a few days if this issue is still there. Usually you could tell around the edges in very dark conditions with the phone dimmed all the way down. You could see green all the way around. Maybe we go to the settings app, you could see green. I'm not seeing that green tint at all. As you can see here, you can't see it on my screen, and I can't see it in this darkness here when I had the lights off, but there is no green tint on my display. However, some people may experience that, and I would love to hear from you in the comments below if you're still seeing it. Now, as far as iPadOS 14.5 beta 6, well, the same fixes apply. Siri just has the same sort of voice options here. So if we go to Siri voice, you've got all the same voices. They haven't updated anything else. They've just matched the betas between the iPhone and the iPad. And like I've said before, I had battery issues with my iPad, so don't expect anything new other than hopefully some better battery, since they seem to be addressing this in the betas with iPhone 11. So hopefully I see better battery on the iPad. I've continued to have issues with the betas with the iPad, and as you can see here, it wasn't charged for a couple days at this point, but I'm still not getting great use on my iPad. Hopefully that improves, and we'll have to see over the next few days. But battery on my iPhone with beta 5 was okay. So if we go to settings, we'll go to battery here. Battery health, you'll see my battery health is at 100% currently, and we'll go to the last 10 days. And yesterday I had 3 hours and 19 minutes of screen on time and 1 hour and 48 minutes of screen off time, and I used 50% of my battery. That would mean I'm only getting about 7 to 8 hours again of screen on time. This seems to be consistent with the betas. I'm only getting about 8 hours of screen on time. However, when I go to bed, I'm still around 50% battery. So I'm not sure if this is reporting accurately. We know from the beta that they're updating it, and there's definitely some issues as far as that goes. So we'll have to wait and see if this is more accurate with this time around, and hopefully it is, and I get much better battery life. And those of you on iPhone 11s should definitely see an improvement, I would think, since they're focusing on that. Now, as far as performance goes, it seems to be pretty good so far. I noticed immediately that things seem to be fairly quick. So on the iPhone 11, for example, most things seem to be nice and smooth, and the benchmarks also show this. So I'll show you that in just a moment, but you'll see everything seems to be smooth. I don't see any issues when I'm actually closing out applications. I didn't with beta 5, and I don't see any issues now closing out applications, and you'll see everything is nice and smooth. I'm not even seeing any lag this time around whatsoever anywhere. So hopefully that's improved. Also, Bluetooth was an issue before, so hopefully that's improved as well. I didn't have issues on beta 6, but some people did. Now, as far as the benchmarks, let's go ahead and take a look at those. We'll go into Geekbench here. And I ran this a couple times initially because the results were very low, but now they're quite good. On my iPhone 12 Pro Max, I scored 1,604 for single core, 4,147 for multi-core. And if we go to the overall history here, you'll see that March 31st and March 23rd were actually up on both of those numbers. So we're getting better performance based off the benchmarks. All I did was wait about few minutes, maybe 3 to 5 minutes, and then ran it again and it went up. So this is good news as far as that goes. Let's take a look at all of these devices and see what they're showing. On the left, I have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. In the middle is the iPhone 11, and on the right is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. These scores should give you a general idea of what to expect if you're using one of these devices, and are not really an overall measure of performance over time, but just an initial test, and it seems to be pretty good. Now, I did a separate video about this yesterday, but Apple announced WWDC 2021 for June 7th to the 11th. Every year they have this event where they show off the next versions of iOS and iPadOS and Mac, for example, and it's on June 7th. So you can expect a keynote or a performance on June 7th showing off all the latest information about iOS 15 and iPadOS 15 and watchOS 8 and macOS 12. So expect that. Of course, usually these are streamed online, and that's usually around 1 p.m. Eastern time or 10 a.m. Pacific time. Now, as far as iOS 14.5 release candidate, well, we weren't sure if this was going to be beta 6 today or release candidate, but it looks like Apple is really refining what they're doing with this. And based on what we have today, I would expect release candidate next week. I'd be very surprised if we see beta 7. It's very rare to see that many betas. So I would expect a release candidate maybe on the 6th or the 7th with a final release the following week on the 12th or 13th. However, they could release it sooner than that or even later if we do have a beta 7. So at this point, some people are saying we'll have an April Apple event. If we do, expect it to release after the event if we hear about that. If we don't, I would expect it sometime around the 12th or 13th of the month in April. So something around that time. Now, should you install iOS 14.5 beta 6? Well, I think that depends if you're on the beta or not. If you're on beta 5, well, then absolutely we need to test it, report any issues and feedback, and continue to see if it's improved. Since it seems like it should improve battery and some other things based on them working on that code with battery health. So I would expect maybe that's a focus this time around. Now, if you're on iOS 14.4.1 or iOS 14.4.2 or earlier, and you're wondering if you should try out the beta, well, I generally recommend people wait till the public releases come out if they're trying to solve an issue. However, if you want to try some of the new features, such as the face unlock when you're wearing a mask using your Apple Watch with Face ID, for example, that's available in these betas. And if you want to try them out, that's fine. However, just know that the idea of a beta is it could be unstable and you may eventually have to wipe your device and start over if you have severe issues. So far, it seems to be fairly stable, but we'll know with a follow-up in a few days when I have a follow-up usually around Sunday where I do a follow-up and go over all of the issues and what battery life was like and more. But so far it seems to be fairly stable, but generally if you're on the beta, I recommend updating. If you're not, I usually don't unless the regular public release is really bad. But so far 14.4.2 seems to be mostly good, but there are some issues that are addressed in 14.5. So that's it for iOS 14.5 beta 6. I was really surprised we had a beta 6. I thought we'd have a release candidate, but at this point, it seems Apple is really refining things and making things much better. Let me know about your experience so far in the comments below, and if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.